Hey, buddy, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. Well, we're still waiting for our next video to cross 5,000 likes. We have a couple that are very, very close, so definitely go check out those episodes if you missed them from this past week. And thank you again, everyone, for those of you who go back and like those and just watch the videos every single day. I really appreciate it. Let's get on closer to All Blind Items Week. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you a rare stream meme of the day. Brought to you here by Date Technical 2421. Title thread was Sin Got Betrayed by Botfly on Stream. Yes, indeed. For those of you who missed that stream, essentially what happened was that I was going to move a barrel into position to get a tinted rock, and Botfly interrupted a shot that was meant for me from one of the orange fires and actually shot the barrel that I was pushing. And not only caused me to take damage, but also exploded the barrel. So that was fun. That was really good. That's some Kaizo Ironmon luck right there. Oh, man. C-Day is going to be Delta Whiskey Tango Romeo Foxtrot November Mike. We've got good tiers. We've got good damage here. Terrible movement speed, but we have Worm Buddy Coach. Worm Buddy going to start us off right here with a fantastic follower that not only deals damage, but also scissor. We're not going to be able to get her. I don't know if that's nice or cruel, game. I don't know. We're also starting with Book of Belial. But, yeah, Worm Buddy, fantastic starting item for us here because it does allow us to have an immobile target, but also allows us to just freely deal damage, and it deals damage by itself. So, I mean, Worm Buddy is just, you know, Worm Buddy is just the CC god. It's like having Anima Sola cast for you, essentially. Now, unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get... We're not going to get any soul hearts or anything like that yet. And I don't think we're going to be able to get Little Sissy as much as I would love to. We have no bombs, no keys, no money. So, yeah. I don't know if that's cruel or if that's neat. I feel like it's more cruel, the fact that we have Sissy there. We can't do anything with her. Get hot bombs. I am going to take hot bombs only because I want to have the five bombs. We also have the Soul of Eden, which serves as a reroll. But, unfortunately, we don't have anything to reroll except Sissy. And even if we reroll Sissy, we're not going to be able to get her, so... not sure where the secret room is. Actually, I do know. It's right here. Never mind. Don't listen to me. Use another bomb here so we can get access to this wooden chest. The wooden chest is guaranteed to have some kind of either... You know what? I shouldn't be taking these, actually. Let's see what we get out of there. We got an Empress card, a World card, and two of Hearts. Yeah, so we can use the Eden Soul to reroll all of this stuff. Even though it'd be nice for like a reroll for an item pedestal, but you know, more likely than not, we're not going to get one. So, and there's no reason to reroll Sissy because we literally can't get her anyway. So, and you know what? It gave us a soul heart. I'm fine with that. We do need ourselves a Yave though, so I will go in here. You know what? I'm gonna be greedy and take the. I'm gonna take the extra soul heart. I'm just gonna be greedy about it. So we leave Little Sissy, unfortunately, but we have not a bad start here with the Book of Belial, especially. Yeah, so far we have the Kaizo Ironmon luck upon us. Those of you who don't know what that is, it is a very difficult. It's a Pokemon challenge designed to not be beaten. But all my friends have been playing it lately. Strippin's been playing it. Krendor's been playing it. And they, it's basically like a contest to see how far you can get. And I'm not going to explain all the rules, but basically you only get one Pokemon. And that's it. And everything is random, including what you get in the lab. Yada, yada, yada. So, and of course, you take that huge amount of randomness into the mix. Like all the Pokemon that you get are random. All their moves are random. Stats are random. Nature is random, et cetera, et cetera. You throw all that into the mix with Sinvicta luck, and you got yourself a recipe for disaster. Or possibly hilarity, depending on, I guess, how much you like me and how much you hate me. I'm just going to do that here so we get plenty of keys, and we also get a golden Yave. We might as well go into the Shopperino here, and I'd love to get, if we could, the treasure map would be nice. We get 5 cents here, maybe, yeah. There we go. We got exactly 15 cents from that shop, and that's very rare considering that we usually get like maybe 7 or 8 cents. Let me do a little bit of a cheeky... Wow. A little bit of a cheeky bit of damage there with the cube of meat. I want to get this Tinted Rock here as well. Let's go back before we go do that. Let's go see what else we can get here. Yeah, usually we get about 7 or 8 cents if we make a withdrawal from the donation machine. So we'll leave that there for now. Our item room is most likely going to be to the north. Go up there. Golden chest, perfect time for it. Look at that. We get enough money here. We might not even have had to use the donation machine. But we've been putting a lot back in there anyway, so it's no big deal. Worm buddy, we love you. Doing God's work here. Birdcage is going to give us a fat buddy, which is essentially it's like dead bird, except like it does like a fissure attack and it just deals more damage than dead bird. So it's not a bad item. You know, it is nice to have a little bit of value given to you if you take damage. Get Worm Buddy, go. Look at that slow. You got to love him. We get a Soul Heart and an Eternal Heart as well. I tell you what. Secret Room might be here. Yeah. Oh, wow. Yeah, we definitely could have gotten that treasure map and a whole lot more had I not withdrawn there. Whoops. We got another Soul Heart anyway. And we get even more Soul Hearts. I'm just going to go for the Gusto here. Okay. Wow. Okay, well, we've got a whole absolute butt ton of damage. And by damage, I mean HP. We'd love to get some movement speed if possible. We have one bomb left here for this Tinted Raku, and we get, yeah, that's going to give us two more swords. Good lord, man. I don't know who I owe the pleasure of dining with today, but I don't know what that means. But man, Worm Buddy absolutely destroying Blighted Ovum. We somehow get a range upgrade instead of a movement speed upgrade, which I'm actually kind of offended by. But we'll go ahead and take the pentagram, and yeah, we've got one hell of a good start. And we could have gone into the alt path door with a golden key just to see if there's any money in there, but I didn't. Are you okay with that? Can you deal with that, society? No? Well, too bad. It's Saturday here. We just had our Star Wars break. The Masterwork break. Thank you, everyone who came by. Wow, we had a planetarium as well. I love doing those. I love doing breaks in general. It's just fun. Having trading cards. Get a case of trading cards. Break them for people. See what people get. Cheer them on. It's always a good group activity. Venus, which is going to give us even more HP. Not that we need it anymore in the first place, but we'll take it. Item room? No, curse room. He's your Venus. He's your Isaac. You're the cider. I don't know. Yeah, we can easily afford to go into the curse room here. Look at Belial giving us a nice damage buff as well. It essentially doubles your damage to a certain extent. It doesn't quite double your damage, but like it kind of does. It's weird. It just gives you a damage bonus. That's all you need to know about Book of Belial. And also a slight chance for a better chance for a deal with the devil, which obviously we're looking towards getting because we've got a absolute ton of damage. Here's our shop. Actually kind of a weird spot for the shop. I would have expected it to be the item room here. Which means that this basically tells me that the item room's to the far right at this point. I am tired of getting hit by sliding dingles here. So that little charm effect that you see there is a direct result from Venus, and we get restock. Which, you know, restocks, the jury's still out on restock, whether or not it's still worth it or not. I don't know, man. It doesn't, most of the time for me, like, restock doesn't feel worth it because it's very rare that you're going to get an opportunity to have that much money to actually utilize it to the fullest extent. And with the fact that it, like, you know, increases the amount of money that things cost now, it's just, it doesn't feel worth it to me. You know, if you have excess money, you've got tons of different ways of generating money, then sure, go for it. But restock is not one of the premium items that I look forward to anymore. Even, honestly, even with Steam sale, like, it's just not as appealing as it used to be. It really isn't. Secret rooms should be here, pretty much guaranteed. to Yabes, and this is going to be going towards our item room here. Normally, I would say don't use your last bomb, but we used it. I mean, it was to get into the secret room. I knew it was there anyway, so... And then to get out of the secret room. It's a little bit lazy. I'm skipping one room, but eh, not worried about it. Get that key on the way back here. They may have noticed me stopping before going any further in this room. It's because all the Diglets were going to submerge. And sometimes if you give them an opportunity, they'll spawn behind you. And it just makes the room harder. So move in a little bit and then stop. That's all you have to do to avoid that from happening. Don't give them any space to spawn behind you, and hopefully they won't. Although sometimes they do have a tendency to spawn like literally underneath you, which is always fun, but the chances of that happening are kind of low. Super secret room should be to the right here, pretty much guaranteed. Seeing the charm effect from Venus there absolutely destroy things for us, which I love. Yeah, we can get some money. Get a cardio coin. Wow. Get ourselves a nickel as well. We have negative luck, so... surprised at how much money that we're receiving here. Yeah, we can play the judgment. I don't see any reason not to. He might as well, since he's right here anyway. He might pay out with, like, something useful. Be great. Sun card gives us a full heal. I mean, we could use that on the next floor or heal us now and take all this money away in front of Bumbo, which I am actually completely fine with because Bumbo is absolute garbage. Literally and figuratively. Wow, we get another cardio coin and another nickel as well. So we essentially just get back all the money that we just spent on basically nothing. I'm fine with that. Unfortunately, the charmed enemies can't hit themselves, which I would really like for this situation here. Look at Worm Buddy go. I'm talking about Worm Buddy. That's how you get the big time player status. Okay, Fistula should be a piece of cake here with Charm and Worm Buddy. Should be. The reason why charm is a factor because it will run into itself. Well, hypothetically anyway, it should run into itself. There we go. Get a tears up, a much needed tears up here, but still want some movement speed if we could. Still a good start. Check the north up here real quick, and then we'll head on down. Yeah, we'll take Locus of Death. Your front card as well. I'm going to waste half of a soul heart here, but I think that's okay. Perfect placement on the troll bombs right there. Definitely take it. Yesterday's run was a lot of fun. Getting double boss rush is really difficult to do. Even under good circumstances, it's difficult to do. So that was a little bit of a treat. We'll go into this cursed room here, and we can get out essentially scot-free. Now, that arcade is interesting because it has two Three Skull Montes in there, which all have the chance to pay out with, like, an item pedestal, and then we can re-roll it and stuff. But the thing is that, like, making Three Skull Montes pay out even once, like, if there's only one of them, is already difficult enough. But making two of them pay out, you got to have some supreme luck. And then on top of that, if you have any money to spare after spending it on both of the Three Skull Montes, then you have to use that to re-roll stuff. And I'd rather have the ability to buy stuff in the store first. Of course, there's no premium item in there that I want. obligatory, but Broken Modem is very good. I don't care. Broken Modem is just a it's just an item that I dislike because it breaks up the flow of things. I cannot believe we didn't get hit there. I was walking away from that shot like, yeah, there's no way we're going to be able to thread the needle. 84% deal with the devil chance now. Get back off there, Larry. All right, so surely, especially with the fallen here, we're going to get a devil deal here, right? I mean, there's no way, not even Sinvicta can fail an 84%, right? Right? All right. Get Incubus here from Fallen. And I guess get the quarter? Question mark? Yeah. Keep making our way to Boss Rush. Gonna check up here once again. It doesn't cost us much to check one room. The reason why I'm doing this is not because I think there's anything in this room, but maybe something up there. A golden leash? Sure. I mean, I don't mind having the Locus of Death is fine, but like this is kind of okay, I guess. Like it brings Incubus closer to us, so in a way, I mean, Isaac basically just has like 20/20 except no damage penalty, in a way. I mean, it's like cheap man's 20/20. Yeah, well, we can use one of these fool cards or one of these moon cards to get out of the boss fight, because we just had another one drop. So let's just go do that real quick. And then our item room is most likely going to be to the far left, I would assume. There you go. Venus, again, using the charm ability to use that contact damage that enemies deal to each other against them. Did anyone see that spike, like, kind of, like, delay for a second there? Or did I just mistime that? That was odd. I mean, I clearly mistimed it, but there was a weird, like, little, like, half-second delay there. Nod Leaf is going to be great with an orbital. Effectively making us completely invulnerable to damage while still dealing damage. Not a particularly exciting way to play, but is one way to ensure victory at all costs. And it's definitely sort of like if all else fails, if you're on like someone like Tainted Lost or Tainted Jacob or someone, you just need to deal damage without taking damage. And, you know, Nod Leaf and an orbital is the classic way to go. Hey, whatever gets the job done, you know? Drop a bomb here, see if we can get a soul heart. We didn't. It's a great job by Worm Buddy. Again, showing you how nice it is to have Some kind of crowd control. Just picture this room without having that little stoppage right there, and how valuable it is to be able to just have a slight interrupt in their pathing. It makes a world of difference. It really does. A soul heart here from champion, blue champion Larry Jr. Get a compass. So we have the map compass effect now, which I am fine with. We still have one more shop to go, so I'm not going to spend too much here. We need to get a move on if we want to make boss rush on the next floor, though. Wasn't looking for the super secret room because it can't be there. Okay, so what we really want is some movement speed. Super secret room should be to the left of here. Oh, it's not. Okay, well, I'm not entirely sure where it is, but we don't have time to look. Plus, I mean, super secret rooms are just, like, not that great anyway. I was talking about it on stream the other night where, you know, super secret rooms are just, they're, unless if you really truly need the HP or like need like a miracle, like confessional booth or something, generally speaking, or if you have PhD, they're not really worth it. In my opinion, anyway. use the birdcage here to finish off Gish. We got less than 3 minutes to get to Mom. But we have the map compass effect. First, the unknown doesn't matter, and we've got a long freaking way to go. We only have one bomb, so we can only bomb our way out of one room here. And you wouldn't think that it would take us that long to get there, but remember, our movement speed is absolute garbage. So it's going to take us a while, even if it's like a short distance. whatever, game. That is another thing I kind of wish that the game wouldn't do is discolor the shots if they're slowed. Especially since, like, the default color for Isaac's tears are white. Makes it kind of difficult to keep track of what's slow, especially if it's super slow, like that bone from the Cubone there, from the Bony. I saw that schmoove there. Worm Buddy had you locked down. Still got out of there anyway. But we did make it to Mom. Worm Buddy is not strong enough to hold down the foot, though. But strong enough to slow her, though. Which increases our uptime on the target, which therefore increases our DPS on the target. Absolutely no way I was going to be able to get out of the way of that one. There we go. Plenty of time for boss rush here. We're going to take a Thame as well as Gimpy just for the extra HP. And we'll take a look at the incredibly awesome boss rush here. So many, many wonderful items. Diplopia, which is not really going to help us out that much. Okay. Maybe there's something good in the item room that we can double. Get some good value out of those sacks, though. I don't know what this room is. I really don't like it, but one thing I do know is that I'm going to diplopiate the hell out of this room. Wow, we lost a lot of HP. Even after giving up the devil deal, or taking the devil deal rather, that was a lot of HP that we had lost. Emperor card seals the deal here. God love it. Now we got to go all the way back to the item room. Two hearts duplicates our red hearts. So if we have one red heart container filled and we have, like, say, five total containers, we'll heal for a total of two red hearts. If we had two heart containers, we'd heal for four. Not there. We've already been in the secret room. So we can get into the curse room for what is essentially free with all those soul hearts that we made with Diplopia. Diplopia purchase was definitely a good one. See the Globins running into each other here. It was free anyway. Grab our soul hearts here. And, you know, it's, we don't have, like, incredible damage. We don't have incredible anything really right now. We could take Found Soul, which would deal, I mean, it's essentially like another DPS dealer, so it gives us something, so we'll take it. So we have a long way to go. Essentially, the furthest possible spot to spawn away from the boss here. Secret room is probably here. Yeah, I gotta remember that found buddy does drop a bomb. Keep that steam sail. Yeah, that's a pink champion right there, and it's still alive. That is a worrying sign of the times here for our damage. Even with Incubus and Found Soul Buddy adding to our DPS a little bit, it's still not great. We're gonna have to outlast this run pretty much, which we've been able to do so far despite having really bad movement speed. There's no way we get out of this room without taking a hit. No way. Wow. I thought for sure we were going to get hit in that room 100%. With how many eye lasers there were, plus our movement speed, I thought we were absolutely boned in there. Doing good. I mean, we're surprisingly sturdy in this run. That's what they used to call me in college. Surprisingly sturdy. Oh no, found soul buddy, oh no. Get shot speed and tears up. And Satanic Bible and Book of the Dead. I mean, we might as well take Satanic Bible at this point because there's no more, officially there's no more HP or no more boss items to be had on the run. And once again, we have spawned in the absolute furthest point that you could possibly spawn from. So we do get a Tears Up, which is going to be a nice little DPS boost, which is what we needed for sure. But like at this point, if we're not going to get movement speed, we absolutely want to get more damage. Again, Venus absolutely wreaking havoc here. Just showing you the potential for all kinds of silliness you can get into a charm. Which is what makes Sissy so good as well. You know, people would like to joke about how Sissy's not a big-time player, but I beg to differ. Give me a good charm effect, and I'll give you a cleared room. One part where I wish the charm effect would be a little bit more effective. Unfortunately, the Diglets, what happens is they will spread out a little bit too much, so it really reduces the chance of them firing at one another. Come on, Worm Buddy. Come on, Worm Buddy. There you go. And look at that. Talk about your big time plays. Oh, it got a Diglet off right at the very end. Get out of here. More and more soul hearts to shake a stick at. We don't want the eternal heart, to be honest. Because we want to maintain our polar invincibility. In case we get hit, we have our orbital to deal damage with our invincibility shield. As long as we stay under one full red heart container. I think one of them hit. I don't think both of them hit. You combine the slow from Lil Gish and from Worm Buddy. That's a really, really slow mama. And no devil deal, no problem. Seagram should be here pretty much guaranteed. Got ourselves a golden key in case we find any chests. We could bomb our way into the secret room as well as the or curse room as well as the mob trap room. Let's take a little gander. Nothing that I see that particularly gets my interest going. Oh no, found soul buddy, oh no. I have zero interest in fighting Black Death, although we're gonna get hit because I got stuck in a pot of all things. Go ahead and take my soul heart back, thank you very much. Karma. Venus instantly activating on the white bomb lampreys. And the reason why they're exploding was because they have eternal flies on them, and when they get charmed, the eternal fly is not charmed. So they get killed by their own orbital, which is just hilarious, and they deserve it. I hope it hurt a lot. See the double slow here coming out from Worm Buddy and from Lil Gish. Super slow combo. Super slow tag team champs. Now, we probably could use Gnawed Leaf for the crack the sky, this part right here. So we really just don't have to worry about taking damage from those. It's actually a little bit faster than running up towards one of the corners. The Worm Buddy sealing the deal, getting the Dunkerino. Down goes Isaac. Man, just a fantastic showing of that. For all intents and purposes, we have not had a whole lot to operate with here, and we've done a very good job at staying afloat. So we'll definitely take it. We will definitely take it. So, you know, it's all around good Saturday run. So thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed it. Oh no, found soul buddy. Oh no, I'm gonna utilize the Thame here to burn down Blue Baby. Look at the charm flies just go nuts. Look at that. We get our HP back anyway. So if you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. And thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. Have a great Saturday. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Known Roach, Jose Zen, Daniel Kwan, Mark J. Cameron, Matt Blandford, and Yevhen Mrozek. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Sinvicta.